Hello, my name is Kirk. I'm a senior principal engineer working with the GSE team. This video is dedicated to demonstrating how to shrink a Microsoft SQL Server Database transaction log file. We'll review the different ways to shrink the transaction log and what to do if the shrink log operation fails to run as expected. So we have a couple of different ways to shrink the log file. We can go into SQL Server Management Studio, go to the properties of the database and do the shrink operation there. And we're going to demonstrate that first off. Then we also have the operation of doing the tsql shrink file command. The other thing that we want to discuss in this particular video is what happens if the shrink file operation fails to run as expected. And we're going to discuss options you'll want to take in that case. So let's go ahead and get into Studio Management. We're going to be working with the AdventureWorks 2017 database. And if we go to Task on the database menu and come down to Shrink, we have two different options. We could work at the database level, dealing with all files within the database, or dealing with specific files. And in this case, we definitely want to go with specific files. Now, by default, you're going to see, if you're looking at our palette here, we have data that's showing up under the file type. We're not going to do anything with the database file. Instead, we're looking to shrink the transaction log. So the transaction log is literally log under the file type. Now, we have some information about the database. The database log is fairly small. This is a new database. And we see the size that's allocated to that transaction log, and we see free space. And free space can be important, because without free space, we cannot execute a shrink file operation on a database. There's several different options. We're not going to go into a whole lot of detail on here, but we have the option to release unused space, which is basically truncating the transaction log. So we could run this by just clicking OK, and it would go ahead and do a shrink or do an attempted shrink on that database. But instead of that, we're going to go ahead and take a look at the tsql option for shrinking the database. I'm a bit lazy today, so I'm going to go ahead and come up to script action to clipboard, which is going to pull the transaction. tsql command that would have been run if we had clicked OK here. And I'm going to go ahead and click cancel. And we're going to go ahead and paste in the tsql command for doing a shrink on our AdventureWorks 2017 database. Now, to go through the command, once again, it's a shrink file command. We're dealing with the AdventureWorks 2017 log, and we can specify how small we want that log to be. In this case, we're going to keep it to the default of zero. So if you don't define anything here, or you leave the value as zero, it will attempt to shrink the file to the original file size. We have the truncate only option, which is giving up free space within the transaction log back to the OS. So as we run that, now we have a report of what it did and current size. So it went ahead and reduced it down to around a meg, which is great for us. A lot more additional disk space given back to us there. So one of the things we also want to discuss in this video is what happens if we run shrink file and it fails to run successfully. So the number one reason why the shrink file operation would fail is because there's not enough free space within the database to execute the shrink file command. So the first thing we will want to do is to figure out the amount of free space within the file. Now, we did see it through the GUI menu there. We can also run this particular command against. Now, we have changed our focus here. We're working with the AdventureWorks 2019 database instead. And running this particular command, the select command, it'll give us the amount of free space that is seen in that database. Currently, we're seeing 3 megs of free space within the database. Now, there are two different options that we could use to try to reduce the database in a case where we've ran out of free space within that particular database. We can change the option, the recovery option, for AdventureWorks 2019, the AdventureWorks 2019 database. Now, if we change the recovery option to simple, and we run the dbcc shrink file command, it should reduce the file down to a size that is much smaller than the original size. And whenever we're putting our database into our database into simple mode, we're just the transaction log is dealing with active transactions, and anything that's not active is being flushed out of the log. So we can run this particular command. Most production databases will be in full recovery. So going to simple allows us, or at least gives us a chance to run the shrink file command successfully. So we're in simple mode. And once again, our scenario is we were failing to run this successfully. After going to simple mode, we run the shrink file operation successfully. It gives us the information about the new file size. And the last thing we would want to do in that particular case is put it back into full recovery mode. So at this point, we've taken an unmanageable transaction log file in terms of using the shrink file command and actually brought it to a state where we're able to shrink that file, and we've put it back into a mode where it now can be backed up to ensure that we get the latest transaction information. That concludes our demo of how to shrink a Microsoft SQL Server database transaction log. Thank you for watching.